Hello. Today we're going to be talking about ACM Private CA certificate templates. The learnings in this session will enable you to secure communication within your internal applications. This includes workloads such as TLS client server apps, MTLS container to container workloads, IoT applications, ADFS for Windows servers, and much more. Before we begin in certificate templates, let's give a brief background on certificates in general and their properties. Let's talk about the structure of a certificate. Certificates have such attributes as the issuer name, the validity period, the subject name, public key algorithm, the subject public key, as well as optional extensions. Now, all these attributes can be predefined by a PKI operator for end users to create. And you may want to restrict or specify certain attributes for your organization. Let's talk about extensions in more detail. There are a few kinds of extensions I want to talk about, starting with the basic constraints. The basic constraints indicate whether the certificate is a CA certificate or an N entity certificate. The key usage specifies cryptographic operations that the certificate can perform. As an example, you may want to specify that signatures are allowed, but encipherment is not. Then we have the extended key usage. This specifies the purpose of the public key contained within the certificate. As an example, you may say that the certificate is a server end of a TLS connection, or it may indicate that the key may be used to secure email. So where do certificate templates come in? Well, certificate templates enable PKI operators to control and specify their X.509 certificate extensions. ACM Private CA uses configuration templates to issue both CA certificates as well as N entity certificates. When issuing a certificate, the appropriate template is then applied. There are many use cases for private certificate templates. However, the main purpose is to match the relevant certificate extensions for the particular use case. Some use case examples are N entity certificates with TLS clients and servers. There's OCSP signing certificates, which creates a mechanism to check if a certificate has been revoked. And there's code signing certificates, where developers can digitally sign software to ensure that it hasn't been modified. There are many more examples that templates enable you to build, but these few show the extensibility and customization possible through certificate templates. So we're going to jump into a demo which showcases creating and using certificate templates for an email use case. We will begin within the ACM Private CA console. As you can see here, we've pre-created two certificate authorities. The one that's highlighted is the root certificate authority. Underneath the root CA, we have the subordinate certificate authority, which is highlighted here. Within the demo, we will be issuing certificates off of the subordinate CA. Now let's move over to Cloud9 to discuss certificate templates. Now we are in Cloud9. We've pre-created a workshop environment within this cloud-based IDE, which we will be running through the demo. Let's open that now. Okay. What we will start by doing is we will issue a code signing certificate with a base certificate template. This means that we have not altered nor modified the certificate template with any custom attributes. Rather, we are using a predefined template that AWS offers. this script will go ahead and it will issue a code signing cert from the certificate authority that we just looked at. The thing I want to highlight here is within the issue certificate API call. As you can see, we are selecting the subordinate certificate authority that we just showed you. And we are using a predefined template right here. This template is a code signing certificate template, meaning all the attributes are already configured to be used for code signing purposes. Let's look at those attributes now. Okay, now we're on the AWS documentation page for ACM Private CA. As you can see, there are a number of what we call base templates. These are pre-configured templates that you can use to issue common certificate types. As you can see, the first one listed is what we are using within this first demonstration, which is the code signing certificate. However, there are many others, including an entity certificate, a client-based entity, as well as a server-based entity, and many others. Let's look at what the code signing certificate looks like. Okay, so here it is. Now, the two areas that I want to highlight is the key usage and the extended key usage. As you can see, this template pre-configures these for you to be critical, as well as digital signature for key usage, and critical and code signing for extended key usage. This means that this certificate can only be used for code signing purposes. The rest of these attributes are passed in through the CSR, the certificate signing request, which we've created within the code that I'll show you, as well as from the CA certificate. Okay, so let's hop back over and actually issue this certificate. Okay, now that we're back in Cloud9, we will run the script, which will issue the code signing certificate. Now this script does a few things and it'll take about a minute. It first and foremost will look for the certificate authority, that subordinate CA that we looked at. Once it finds it, it will issue a certificate off of that subordinate. It creates a certificate signing request right here. And then packages it here, the certificate signing request. And then finally, it uses this API call to ACM Private CA called issue certificate. And it uses that template arm that we talked about to then issue the code signing cert. Okay, it's successfully completed. So let's look at that code signing cert. Now we can open it up. We can open up the PEM file and we could see the certificate. But let's look at the actual attributes within it. So we'll run this OpenSSL command to look at the certificate. As we can see, this is the certificate that we issued. And as we saw within the code signing template, the template actually sets the key usage as well as the extended key usage to digital signature as well as code signing like we talked about. And as you can see, that successfully worked. So from a PKI operator perspective, you just have to put in that certificate template ARN, and then you will be outputted with a certificate that follows the attributes of that template. And in this case, it's code signing. So what if you need something more custom that doesn't fit exactly in a predefined template? Well, that's where customizations come in, and we'll talk about that now. In this next example, we need to use the blank end entity certificate with API passthrough. Now, what we're trying to do is we're trying to create an email certificate that's used for signing, as well as an email certificate that's used for encryption. Now, we're going to split these out into two separate certificates, but keep in mind your application may only need one email certificate. We'll begin with the email signing certificate, which verifies the email sender's identity for the recipient. And we'll see here that the API passthrough will allow you to actually pass through certificate attributes that are more custom than a base template provides. So as an example, you can pass in the subject alternative name, the subject with either the API or with the certificate signing request, and we'll show both, as well as the extensions, which are now passed in completely custom to exactly what you need. Certificate templates have an order of operation. For each extension value, the template definition has highest priority, followed by API pass-through values, followed by CSR pass-through extensions. This explains why even if you're using a CSR pass-through, the API pass-through takes precedent and is still useful in those situations. Let's hop back over to our workshop and let's see this in action. So like I said, this is the email signing certificate. And we can see here that we set the subject name. The subject name is the S-MIME signing cert. This is the protocol for secure multi-purpose internet mail extension standard. This is for email certificates. And if we scroll here, we see that the subject name is actually being passed in through the certificate signing request. Because if we remember, you can either pass it in through the API or you could pass it in through the CSR. So we actually pass in the subject name through the CSR. Now, this is to show you the extensibility, right? You have a lot of options here depending on your workflow and your needs. Now, if we look at what we pass in through the issue certificate API call, we actually pass in the extensions through the API. So we do a little bit of both. We do the API pass-through for extensions, and we do the certificate subject name for from the CSR. As you can see, the extended key usage is set to email protection. This means that it can only be used for signing emails. And the key usage is non-repudiation as well as a digital signature. And then we can also give it a subject alternative name of the email that it's coming from. Now, this would be done programmatically within your client. Okay, let's run this. Okay, as we can see, it successfully created the certificate. So now let's go over and look at the certificate again with that OpenSSL command. Okay, now here is the email signing certificate. And as you can see, we successfully created the certificate, but now with those custom key usage and extended key usage, which is passed in via the API, as well as a subject name, which was passed in via the certificate signing request. Okay, and here we go. Now, based on the use of email protection, we have that in the extended key usage, as well as non-repudiation in the key usage. Okay, so now that we've done an email signing, let's do an email encryption example, which is very similar. Okay, now let's jump over to the email encryption certificate. So this will actually do the encrypting of the email. As we can see, it's very similar. So we are still looking for the certificate authority to use. And then we are indicating the name attribute, the subject name, to be the S-MIME encryption cert, because we're encrypting this time instead of just signing. And as you can see, we're passing that in with the CSR to give you the same example of extensibility. This could also be done with the API. It's up to you. And the key difference here is that we're still using the extended key usage for email protection, but the key usage now is key and cipherment, because this is actually encrypting the contents of the email. Okay, so let's run this and create and actually do the issuing for that email encryption cert from the subordinate CA. So we'll run that here. We'll just give it a second. Okay. As you can see, now we've successfully issued the encryption certificate So let's do the same thing and let's look at the contents of the certificate to make sure that everything worked as expected. So first and foremost, you can see we have the subject alternative names still as an example email address. We have the extended key usage to be email protection once again, but now we have key and cipherment as the key usage, since this is actually doing the encryption for that email. This concludes our deep dive on certificate templates. In this demonstration, you've learned about the extensibility of ACM Private CA certificate templates and how to utilize them to achieve your goals. For more information on ACM Private CA, please watch the other videos within this playlist or visit the AWS console to start building for yourself. Thank you.